What's the most awkward situation you've ever been in? Was unexpectedly in the car ride with my boyfriend's parents on their way to sign their divorce papers. Kind of similar vein. My last ex before my husband wanted to stay friends even though we had a messy breakup and I left him. I thought he would want me to duck off, but he kept insisting that we still hang out as a friends. Out of guilt I obliged. Over time he started seeing someone else, and then he still kept getting me to hang out with them. I couldn't tell if things were getting more weird or less weird, so I obliged. One evening I am hanging out with my ex, Bill, at their place. When his GF, Tammy, comes home from work, and looks kinda nervous. Before I know it she launches into this story about having just hooked up with a coworker, as I am desperately wishing to GTFO. My ex was visibly upset, and they had a huge fight about it right in front of me. During the fight it also came out that they had been trying to groom me for a threesome. That was the last time I saw them. But, they are still together. When I was a kid, we were on holiday and decided to go to a church. While we were there I decided that I would be funny if I would slap my dad's ass with both hands. So I ran in full speed to maximize the impact of the slap. I ended up slapping a stranger who also happened to walk next to a woman with a stroller in his hands, which made me think it was my dad. It was even worse that my parents saw it as well. I once followed a man out of a grocery store, across a small parking lot, and tried to get into his car with him because I thought it was my dad. Didn't figure out my mistake until I saw him look across the top of the car at me, trying to get into the passenger side, with a super confused look on his face. Cue my actual dad running up breathlessly, waving his hands and yelling at me. I was sitting in class and the kid next to me farted and I said, "God bless you," as if it were a sneeze. One time in college, I snuck into Myra's room, and hid under the blanket on his top bunk. My goal was to scare him when he came in, and settled down a bit. He ended up coming in with his girlfriend and began making out with her. After a good, lifetime, couple moments, I jumped up and ran out. No saving it. Not awkward for me, but I was the reason for it. I served for a couple years, and worked multiple restaurants in that time frame. I worked at a Denny's, night shift, best and worst job for many reasons. Anyways, there was a regular that came in often, drunk as a skunk and nasty as hell. He tipped really well but was so nasty to us girls. It never fazed me so I served him often. He offered many times to pay for extra service, and tried to get me to leave with him often. Of course I never did, but a couple months later I'm working a new place, little more high end. I work mornings here, and this was a Sunday morning church rush. Guess who was sat in my section? My nasty regular from my last job with his entire family. His wife, kids, parents, the whole group, fresh out of church. The look on this man's face when I walked up and said hello. He was red as a fire truck, and I made it worse by asking if he remembered me. He left me a huge tip, probably because I didn't bring up his nasty mouth and grabby hands from his late drunken nights. Edit, I was a waitress. That's what I meant by serving. Okay, I already posted in this thread, but I remembered something even worse. When I was in second grade, my brother and I would always be picked up after school by my dad. We had a green van with a red stripe on the side, so my brother grabs my hand and storms us up to the car. He rips open the door, sits us down, buckles me in, and then says, "Can we get McDonald's on the way home?" We both look up and there is two middle-aged adults sitting in the front seat that are obviously not our family. They stare at us, we stare at them. In my little brain we've been staring at each other for at least 10 minutes at this point. My brother unbuckles me, unbuckles himself, we get out and walk away. No words were exchanged, we then checked who was in the car before getting in from that point forward. I was a teenager with a boner. Pretty standard so far. I walked downstairs, and had to tuck it in my pajamas so the head is sticking straight up, and the erection is pinned against the body so the boner isn't noticeable. Well, when I put my t-shirt on it fell behind the tip, so if you looked at my wasit line you could clearly see the tip of my penis. I was talking to my mom for a few minutes, and she was flushed red in the face. and quickly trying to kill conversation, not something my mom is known for. I walked away, saw what was going on and didn't know what the hell to do. We never discussed it, but because things were so awkward at dinner, I'm pretty sure my mom knew that I realized it happened as well. This poor girl walked into my lecture by mistake about halfway through. This particular professor really enjoys talking to all of his students, and was super engaging even with 400 plus students in his class. When the girl walked in, my professor stopped teaching, looked at the girl, and asked if she was in the class. She said she was, and began walking towards the front where the open seats were. This is a fairly large lecture hall and all 200 students, approx how many actually show up to class, were now forced to watch this poor girl walk towards a seat because the professor didn't continue talking, and just stared at her. She got close to the front and I think the pressure of the whole room got to her and she said, "Actually no I'm not," and turned around and we all had to watch this poor girl climb back up the stairs and out of the hall. I was literally watching my worst nightmare. I did basically this. Went to an exam on the wrong day, sat there while a few hundred exams were passed out. Okay. You may flip over your exam. Put my name and ID at the top, look at first page dumbfounded by questions, look at second, same. 2 minutes into an exam I had every eye on me as I walked down to the front to turn in the test, and tell them I was in the wrong place then all the way to the back to leave. I've done worse though. Okay, so me and some friends were at a restaurant, and a buddy of mine was telling us about this new girl he just started going out with a few days back. Well, another friend what started telling us about this girl that he banged the previous night. The conversation went on for a minute, and finally somebody asked for the name of the girl that he had banged, and it turns out it was a girl that the other friend had started dating a few days earlier. He narrowly avoided fight as we convinced him it's better to find out she's shitty now rather than later. The two guys still no longer speak though. He narrowly avoided fight as we convinced him it's better to find out she's shitty now rather than later. The two guys still no longer speak though. I never got the idea of getting angry at another guy when your girl cheats on you with them. I mean, yeah, if they know that it's your girl, and decide to have sex with her instead of telling you that she's a cheater, then you have all right to get mad, but from the story it seems like there's no way he could have known it was his friend's girl, so it doesn't make sense to get mad at him. Maybe in the moment, but definitely not no longer speaking to them. I was riding in the passenger seat with my mom, who has always been strict and very tight-knit several years ago, when for some reason she decided to completely open up to me about all of her drug experimentation and sexual exploits in the 60s. And the time she did cocaine with Steve Jobs at a fancy restaurant in the 80s. It was a very uncomfortable eye-opener and I was trapped listening to it. Her mom did cocaine with Steve Jobs? Her ex-husband was an executive with a firm that managed Apple's first large-scale ad campaign. After the first Macintosh launched, they went out to a 5-star restaurant in LA and railed lines of blow under the table apparently. I'm not sure I'm comfortable with that knowledge. I was at a funeral for one of my husband's relatives. On my way in, an employee of the funeral home asked me when I was due. I wasn't pregnant, but I am fat and was wearing an Empire waistcoat, so I wasn't offended. As I signed the guest book, I corrected her and tried to defuse the situation with a joke about burning that coat later. But she just wouldn't stop. She kept trying to apologize and explain herself and I just wanted to run away. Then I was stuck in a small room with her for the next 2 hours. I have sort of an inverse story. When I was pregnant, I gained a lot of weight. One day, while I was very, very pregnant, I was riding up an elevator and someone on the other side waved at me as they were coming down. I did not know them, but I'm friendly so I waved back. They then realized their mistake and came up to explain. They said, "I'm sorry, you looked like my wife," to which I cheerfully replied, "Oh. When is she due?" His wife wasn't pregnant. My 79-year-old mother-in-law with Alzheimer's telling us that she had had sex the previous night with another resident of her nursing home. She had been celibate for 20 years up until then. We think. Boss of mine worked in a retirement home. Apparently, they have a huge STD problem in those homes because why wear protection when your ovaries don't work? The bright side is if you're a virgin, all you have to do is wait till you're old and decrepit, get put in a home, buy tons of Viagra, and get your game on.